What's going on, guys? Brent Still 31. Appreciate you guys tuning in. So just like all camouflage, it's always environment specific. Now in this particular environment right now, we have a significant amount of snow on the ground. However, the snow was not heavy enough to cover the trees and the surrounding vegetation above the ground layer. So we're going to do a mixture today with this is actually Russian camouflage trousers, kind of based off the German design. But we're going to have this snow camouflage trousers with a MultiCam camouflage top. And this particular setup usually is typically good in this type of environment, especially if you're going to be doing a lot of moving. So without further ado, guys, let's put it to the test. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to leave a comment. What's it, guys? That completes this camouflage effectiveness video over this split snow camouflage bottom and camouflage top. Now, I would say take this video as more of a concept video. Obviously, there's a whole host of different snow camouflages out there as well as camouflage tops. So, you know, I went with a multicam today because it's mostly brown and a little bit of green out there. I figured this is probably the best approach. And then the bottoms was this Russian snow camouflage that's very similar to the older German camouflage snow trousers. But you can use any host of camouflage patterns. Obviously, go with the one that you think is going to be best for your environment. If there was more pine trees out here and it was a lot greener, I probably would have went with a woodland or a DPM or something along those lines for the top. So, nonetheless, hopefully this performed very well today, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you're liking what you're seeing, don't forget to check out my YouTube channel. I've done several camouflage effectiveness videos, and I plan to do several more in the future. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to leave a comment.